Welcome to Hamburgers and Horror, the home of meat, monsters, and man-shark hybrids. I'm Noah Hook, and today we're looking at the sci-fi original movie, Hammerhead Shark Frenzy, aka Hammerhead, aka Sharkman. You know it's a bad sign when a movie has three names. Hammerhead follows a group of employees of a pharmaceutical company who have been invited to a remote island by one of their disgraced former peers. This scientist has used shark DNA to save his dying son, but now he has turned into a total man-eater. The group tries to survive when the mad scientist unleashes his hungry son on them. Hammerhead was directed by Michael Oblowitz, director of The Breed, This World, Then the Fireworks, and Frank and Eva. He seems a bit more well-regarded for his avant-garde filmmaking and his documentary work, as most of his feature films aren't exactly beloved. The story was written by Boaz Davidson and Kenneth Badish, who also co-wrote Mansquito, Snake Man, and many other films for sci-fi. Hammerhead stars William Forsythe from Once Upon a Time in America, Raising Arizona, and American Me, Hunter Tylo from The Bold and the Beautiful, and as many of you may have picked up from the intro, Jeffrey fucking Combs. Combs is a B-movie legend starring in Reanimator, From Beyond, Star Trek Deep Space Nine, Would You Rather, The Frighteners, and a ton of other fun films and TV shows. He's definitely the star of the show here. Hammerhead premiered on Sci-Fi in June of 2005 and was released to DVD later that year. It was met with mostly negative reviews, with critics citing its boring protagonists, inconsistent special effects, and too little of its shark monster. Those issues are shared on Rotten Tomatoes, where it only has a 22% audience score. So, I was 8 years old when this movie premiered on Sci-Fi, and I have a feeling my childhood imagination made the movie a lot cooler than it actually was. I also think I conflated this with Peter Benchley's Creature, which played on Sci-Fi as well when I was a kid, so we'll see which parts I remember. But either way, it seems like I'm gonna have a doozy of a movie to get through, so it's probably about time we jump in. I hope you brought some fertilizer, because we're watching Hammerhead Shark Frenzy. The movie opens on an uncharted island in the Pacific where this lovely couple is enjoying the day on their sailboat. They try to race to shore, but little do they know they're being watched from beneath the waves. Hammerhead wastes no time at all ripping the couple to shreds only 2 minutes into the movie. We enter a secret lab on the island where three scientists are attempting to mix human DNA into Hammerhead. Dr. Krause is too trusting of their creation and gets a couple of fingers bitten off. Krause wants to give up, but Dr. Preston King is too excited about their progress and says he is going to send out the invitation. We hop over to a vague pharmaceutical building where we meet Amelia Lockhart and Tom Reed. Amelia is a biologist and Tom is the head of IT, and these two have some workplace romance going on. Now we meet CEO Whitney Fetter, who is making big business phone calls. Whitney says their falling stocks are no concern since they have a new drug coming out. This drug is news to Amelia, and he shows her an email he's received from King. This unexplained formula has Whitney so excited they are heading to King's Island tomorrow. They theorize that King has solved the stem cell riddle, which is basically how to change stem cells for essential medical needs. It can be used to create heart cells after a heart attack, stop degeneration from Alzheimer's, or cure cancer, and it seems King may have figured out how to do it. Whitney tells Amelia to forget about her past with King and focus on the science. Later, Amelia is swimming at work, I guess, and Tom asks what happened between her and King. She explains that she was going to marry his son Paul. Now she's tanning at work, and she tells Tom that Paul died 5 years ago from cancer, and she gets into the big glowing cancer box. Through voice recording, King says he finally feels his years of work are beginning to unfold. The latest injection seems to have worked, and he no longer fears Hammerhead devolving into a mindless killing machine. He believes if he can get the creature to breed, its children will be the key to humanity's future. The intelligence of man and the strength of a Hammerhead shark. Now it's time to see if Hammerhead wants to breed, as this poor drugged woman stumbles around in its enclosure. No, looks like he's still just hungry. The company members arrive at the airport, including Jane and Bernie from accounting, and Whitney's new side piece. King is vlogging again, and he now acknowledges that Hammerhead is cognitively degenerating, becoming more shark than man. He is on the hunt for a woman he will breed with willingly, and he talks about human life thriving in the oceans, the dawn of a new Atlantis. Dr. Krause thinks this process would be easier with an egg-laying shark, but King argues that live birth will mesh with the human body better. But Krause doesn't believe they'll ever control Hammerhead or any potential offspring. Dr. Medvedenko tells King another patient has gone into labor and looks like it's going to be a C-section, but it was all for nothing as the little shark baby is dead on arrival. The company is on a boat to the island and Tom and Amelia are discussing King. She says the government put a stop to his work after they learned he was experimenting with cross-species insemination. As King is feeding a rat to a carnivorous plant, Krause tells him his guests have arrived. The crew arrives at the island and they take some jeeps to King's ridiculous house slash lab. King is surprised to see Amelia and the group tours his greenhouse. Whitney doesn't care about meat-eating plants and King decides to get straight to dinner. Jane notices her satellite phone isn't working and Amelia notices a lot of armed security. During a weird festive dinner, Amelia recognizes Dr. Medvedenko, who was arrested for allegedly experimenting on people in Prague. As everyone has a good time, some random-ass couple is swimming near the island. For an uncharted island, this place has a lot of fucking visitors. As you guessed, Hammerhead proceeds to eat them in choppy close-ups. King is finally giving his presentation as he explains sharks have potentially limitless lifespans and are immune to cancer. King has built a super microscope to look at single strands of DNA and was able to locate where cancerous mutations occurred. He says his subject had kidney cancer, which is what Paul had. The subject rejected newly injected cells until he tried cells that were already immune to cancer, which he got from a hammerhead shark. After injecting him with the shark stem cells, his cancer went into remission in 2 weeks. Amelia asks if Paul is alive, and King shows them his shark son, swimming around in a CGI tank. King announces this is the future of the human race, but Whitney and the others obviously think he's mad. But King doesn't want their help or their opinions as his armed guards step in. He apologizes to Amelia as she loved Paul and he didn't plan on her coming. He says they are guilty of stealing his research and forcing them into exile, and sentences them to death via hammerhead. The mercenaries scare the group back and lock the door, but one drops his gun. Water starts pouring in and Amelia realizes their only exit is a ventilation shaft near the ceiling. Tom finds the gun in the water and shoots out the fan, just as Hammerhead makes his way inside. He goes for Tom, but he's able to shoot him off both above and below water. The group escapes to the roof and they immediately start making a rope out of their shirts to climb down. King doesn't mind as he wants to see what kind of damage Paul can do in the wild, as he also somehow escaped. Some of King's men are repairing an underwater electric fence, and they get eaten because of course. Tom realizes their signal is being jammed, but he may be able to override it at a higher ground. It's morning now, and King wants the humans found dead or alive, except Amelia, who he wants to keep for shark mating purposes. The crew is roaming the island now, and whiny-ass Julie trips into what I thought was a puddle, but apparently it's a body of water large enough for Sharky to hide in. They magically jump to the coast and they spot the boat they came in on. Fearing it may be a trap, they decide to take a closer look. Tom sneaks under the dock and identifies a few hostiles, and Whitney is confident he can bribe them. The boys are going to head over while Amelia protects the blondes. Wait, they're swimming over? They hop on and their plan goes horribly, and Tom just takes out the captain like the action hero he is. These dudes are just unloading on the boat, and Whitney wrestles with this random dude, eventually throwing him overboard. Another random guy comes out and hits Bernie with a wrench, sending him overboard as well. This guy tells his men to hold their fire, even though they haven't managed to hit a single human being after a full minute of shooting. They hit their own guy, and finally hit a barrel of flammable liquid. The boat is going to blow, and the boys dive into the water. Hammerhead decides to join the fun and those shitty mercenaries just peace out. Tom and Whitney reach the dock, but Bernie is falling behind. King cheers on his son as he goes after him. Tom opens up the shark control locker and grabs a catch pole and dives back into the water. Hammerhead gets there first and pulls Bernie under and proceeds to fuck Bernie up real good. Tom shocks Hammerhead with the pole and apparently that's enough to scare him away. Who's filming that? Tom and Bernie get to shore, and Whitney wants to leave his one-legged employee behind. The others refuse, and Whitney and Julie head out on their own. He's reciting Shakespeare to her for some reason, and Hammerhead is watching from the bushes. Julie gets wrapped by one of King's carnivorous plants, but nothing happens. More mercenaries have landed, and Tom sneaks up on one of them. They roll down a hill, and the merc lands on his own tiger pit spikes. Tom is sure to take his gun and sick-ass utility belt. Whitney and Julie are on some rocks now, and apparently this is the highest ground on the island. The helicopter spots them and launches a fucking missile, sending Whitney all the way down and breaking the phone. Now Julie's all alone in the woods, and Hammerhead finally strikes in more shoddy close-ups, and kills Julie off-screen. The others are still trucking along, but Bernie is losing lots of blood. They're back at the lab, and Tom fends off Hammerhead with his gun, and hotwires the door open. He calls them inside, leaving Bernie alone. Hammerhead grabs Bernie, and Tom is just like, yeah, it got him. What the fuck? Tom was just tired of carrying him, I guess. They head into the lab's morgue, and King sends some men after them. I'm just gonna pause the plot real quick, because I think these women are supposed to be in underwater tanks, but they are literally just standing there. Sometimes they're wiggling around and blinking. It's really funny. They find a dead shark baby and realize these dead women were attempts at getting Hammerhead to reproduce. Tom covers the camera, and Amelia learns that Hammerhead has trouble processing nitrogen, which may be its fatal weakness. Tom leaves some sort of trap on the door, and they leave through the vent. This guy walks in, dropping two chemicals together, which burns him up. Two mercs are driving down a path, which a still alive Whitney is hobbling down. They spot him and defeat the old man in melee combat, and take him alive even though their orders have been to kill him. Meanwhile, King is pissed that his shark bait is still alive, and the others are heading to a helipad on the other side of the island. This mercenary named Eric is interrogating Whitney when Hammerhead decides to headbutt the moving vehicle. They go after him for plot purposes, and Whitney steals the Jeep as one of them is killed off-screen. Luckily, our boy Eric is still alive, and King has to triple his salary to get him back out there. Even Medivanko thinks all of this has gone too far, but King knows his son will take care of her if she actually leaves. Tom, Amelia, and Jane spot Whitney, and he crashes into a fucking tree. They tell him about the helipad, and he conveniently knows how to fly. Medivanko shows up and wants to join their ragtag brigade, and mercenary Eric spots them. The helicopter somehow sneaks up on them and launches a bunch of missiles, and everyone is somehow still alive. Amelia tries to help a dangling Medivanko, but she is blasted off into the water below. The helicopter leaves for no reason, and we get more crappy close-ups as Medivanko is eaten. Jane gets really itchy out of nowhere and jumps down into the river to relieve the itch, I guess. You know what happens next, she gets eaten. Wow, what great storytelling. Krause is out on his own now to capture Paul because apparently the mercenaries aren't capable. He lures Hammerhead with some guts and charges his taser, but just gets overwhelmed by the shark man and eaten in more shoddy close-ups. There was a fire for this one, so that's cool, I guess. The world's worst mercenary actually shoots Hammerhead with a tranquilizer, so good for him. And they got him back to the pool. That a boy, mercenary Eric. More mercs come down from the chopper, and Tom kills the first one with a knife throw like it's Call of Duty. Amelia takes one out with a branch, and Tom and Whitney shoot the rest down. King is very proud of his murderous shark son, and once again sends mercenary Eric after the group. A boat spots them, but of course only the good guys land killing shots. Explosion. More explosion. What a great film. They finally made it to the helipad, but my boy Eric isn't far behind. Terminator Tom lays down some cover fire while Amelia and Whitney get to the chopper. Explosion! Mercenary Eric arrives and Whitney tries to leave Tom behind. Amelia puts a stop to that as Tom blows the enemy's helicopter up. None of these trained killers can hit the man standing in plain sight, and he hops on. But the mercs shoot the fuel and they all hop out as the helicopter explodes. The mercs capture unconscious Whitney and Amelia, but not Tom, of course. Amelia wakes strapped to a gurney, and King sticks her with reagent. Actually, I don't know what he sticks her with. Let's say ketamine. He extracts some blood from her armpit while Tom has swam his way to that sailboat from the beginning. What? He finds a spear gun and one handgun, and apparently that was worth the swim out there. Whitney asks what King plans to do to him, but he only gets laughter as a response. Amelia is being prepped in one of those stupid tanks as King explains his plan to turn the human race into shark people, starting with the children born between her and Paul. He believes Paul will remember her smell and mate with her, and to hopefully ease the process, he's going to make sure Paul is well fed beforehand. They dunk Whitney's head down into the tank, and he's killed off screen. Damn it! Tom is back in the greenhouse and happens upon a nitrogen-rich fertilizer. You can tell because it starts with nitro. Amelia is put into position above Hammerhead, and King tells her he is envious of her imminent shark rape. Tom shoots mercenary Eric with a spear, and King fills Amelia with more drugs. He tries to direct Paul towards Amelia, but the shark goes ahead and rips off his dad's arm. He munches on a mercenary, and Tom takes out the other one. Hammerhead pops up, but Tom sprays him with super effective fertilizer, and he submerges. He unstraps Amelia while she continues spraying Hammerhead, and Tom sprays him more until he just explodes. Fucking anticlimactic. They start dumping lots of gas, and Amelia starts shooting all the baby sharks. King is still alive and comes at her with an AK, but Tom shoots him in the back. They shoot the place up together and the entire building explodes. Look at that realistic looking explosion. Tom and Amelia kiss and they sail away to end the movie. And that's Hammerhead Shark Frenzy. This was really bad. It was like pretty bad even by sci-fi original movie standards. Like 80% of this movie is just the characters going back and forth, separating, getting back together, and fighting mercenaries, not the shark monster. And the island layout is completely unexplained, so people are just jumping from woods to beach to rocks to lab, and we don't know where anything is. Most of the characters are paper thin, and they're clearly here just to up the body count. Not to mention the audio is mostly dubbed over and it's not matched up at all. The only performance with a bit of pizzazz is Jeffrey Combs, but he's played so many mad scientists, I'm pretty sure he was just gliding through the script. My biggest issue is Hammerhead and his inconsistent effects. The CGI just looks awful and we don't get a single full body shot of him on land at all. It's clear at least most of a suit was made, and I wish they would have shown it off. I'd take a full body, crappy looking shark costume any day over the same 10 close-ups of different pieces of it used over and over again. And I think that issue kind of speaks to the whole movie's issue. It didn't quite embrace how ridiculous this plot is. It had the opportunity to be a really wild ride, but just played out kind of boring and generic. Objectively speaking, this is probably the worst movie I've covered on the channel so far. It doesn't have many redeeming qualities aside from a so bad it's good kind of quality every so often throughout the film. I did find myself laughing throughout most of the movie, so at least I wasn't bored. If you like sci-fi original movies, this might be for you, but the only other reason I would suggest it is if you really enjoy Jeffrey Combs, but I don't think the movie's really worth a watch. Well, that's about it. Next week, we'll be continuing our Summer of Creature Features with Zombievers. Thank you all for joining me, and an extra thank you to my patrons. As always, I'm Noah Hook, and this has been Hamburgers and Horror. Stay safe out there. Thanks for watching my review of Hammerhead Shark Frenzy. If you enjoyed this review, be sure to like and subscribe so you can keep up with my weekly horror reviews. And if you want to help support the channel further, be sure to check out my Patreon account. You'll be able to vote for future movies and franchises I cover on the channel. Thanks, y'all.